In August 2017, three members of Saracen Group, or in Indonesia we call it Saracen, were arrested. So Saracen is a group of people who spread hate content toward social media to get some money from their clients. And they have more than 2,000 social media accounts to run their business. Can you imagine when hatred becomes such a business? How poor. Since a long time ago until now, hate speech itself has become a big problem for all people around the world. Why? Because hate crime itself is started from hate speech. Genocide in Rwanda and the Nazi massacre toward the Jews are part of history that prove collective hatred leads to discriminate people based on their ethnic, religion, and political ideology. So good morning, all the respected audiences. I'm Asri Jawalia. In this World Speech Day, I will try to ask you to prevent hate speech, or at least decrease it in 5 ways. Thank before speak, recheck information, avoid discrimination content, respect others, and manage ourselves. Hate speech is a tool that attacks an individual or a group of people based on the unprotected attributes such as sexual orientation, gender, religion, country of origin, color of skin, and many other things, dear people. And hate speech itself can be spread towards social media, mass media, banners, religious lecture, and direct speech. And if people say that freedom of speech as the reason of hate speech, I think it's ridiculous, ladies and gentlemen. Because if that kind of speech is poses to attack other people's well-being, it's supposed to be limited and need to be limited, ladies and gentlemen. And there are so many impacts, negative impacts of the hate speech itself. The first one, the worsening of the victim's mental health. The second one, physical assault, harassment, bullying, and even suicide and murder. So what can we do as an individual so we don't become the actors of hate speech? The first one, think before type, especially on social media. Make sure and rethink whether our comment on Facebook or our post contains hate speech or not. And the second one, recheck the information, especially from random blogs, ladies and gentlemen. Hoax usually use provoking or eye-catching titles, right? Yeah. So it makes us curious to open it or even to share it. And the third one, avoid discrimination content. Don't ever try to humiliate other people, other ethnic, and praise our ethnic too much, or provoking people to hate certain group. Because even if we just do it a little, it can be considered as a crime, dear people. In Indonesia especially, we have Constitution of Electronic Information and Transaction, Article 28, verse 2, about hate speech. Do you know John Roo? In 2017 also, he was arrested for spreading hate speech toward his Facebook account. So don't try to share hate speech if you don't want to end up in jail. And the fourth one, respect others. Difference is such a common thing in a world of pluralism. And what makes this world beautiful is the diversity itself. So I once read a quote that says, "A devil is always wrong, an angel is always right, but humans is sometimes right and sometimes wrong." So don't ever judge a person based on their small mistakes, and never judge a group because of one person's mistake. And the last one is manage ourselves. Don't be easy to be provoked, and sometimes we need to give in to avoid bigger problems appear. For example, when we are angry, so just keep silent or post nothing until we are calm enough, dear people. And lastly, the 22nd of July, No Hate Speech Movement expresses solidarity for the victims of hate crime. But here, I ask all of you to not only express that kind of solidarity on 22nd of July, but every day, so that we can realize a world full of peace instead of hatred. Thank you. I'm Asri Shawalia. Good morning.